Welcome to episode 3 of the playthrough of The Shattering, a game released earlier this year by Super Sexy Software. First two episodes I'll put a link to in the description, but as far as we've got, just to keep it as brief as possible, we've gone into the corridor of the hotel room that we're staying in as our latest memory, and we've just literally opened the door to our hotel room 611. Some odd goings on so far in the memory of John, and so we'd assume things will only become more odd, but we'll have to see. I've never played this before, so everything is new to me as well. Just a recommendation, play the game with headphones rather than just standard audio output, because the audio, the music and the general effects are much better with the headset on. The game recommends it, and actually I can see why. So where you can, pop some headphones on and get stuck in. So we'll carry on from where we left off, which is going into the hotel room and seeing what other strange things might happen. So let's have a look. So we'll just start, as I said before, I've got a thing about opening doors and just seeing if they work. It's nice to see we've got some wardrobe space at least. So our trusty suitcase always seems to follow us. And these messages always seem to sort of at least give us some descriptions to what's going on and what our character's thinking. That's probably the only clue in the game that we actually get as to what is happening. Again, one slight thing that I can't get my head around is sort of a lack of direction. It just seems to be a case of click on everything and something will eventually happen. Our door's moving, I just noticed that. That's really strange. We'll ignore that for the time being. Okay, so finally a piece of quiet, cigarette to calm down, and my typewriter is all I need. Well, we know we have a typewriter, so I guess we should find the typewriter and a cigarette, or a cigarette. So we can see there's some cigarettes. I spotted these just as I turned around a moment ago and looked at the door, but here we go, Lion Roar, that famous brand, eh? Smoking may cause brain damage and loss of memory. Pretty sure I've never read that warning before. But, yeah, why not? Something new, something fresh. Right, so we've got cigarettes. But as this says, we don't have a lighter, so I guess the next thing is to try and find a lighter and or the typewriter, as mentioned here. So, can we interact with anything in this room? Obviously the lights, because this game does love a light. Pretty much play with most lights in this game. Let's hope. In fact, the game is more than just switching lights on. Don't let me suggest that it's boring like that, because it's interesting. Wine. We do like wine. Azure Gardens. Semi-sweet. Smashing bottle. Put it back for the time being, I guess. Just one thing, when you pick an item up and then you click it again, the game kind of decides what to do with it. So in this case, the bottle of wine, it gets put back automatically. I'm not choosing to do that. Whereas some items, if you pick them up and you click them again, you'll use them in some way. So like the cigarettes, for example, they went straight to my inventory by the looks of it. The game decides what to do for you on that sense, so it's one of those other things. So what have we got? So this is our bedroom. Not too shabby. We could sit down on this. A lot of sitting down in this game as well. Yeah, sat down enough. Yeah, that noise is slightly annoying from the TV, so we'll turn that off. Now what are we doing? Typewriter and lighter. Don't let me get distracted by things like opening windows, like I usually do. Is this a lighter? It is a chocolate. Again, game has decided to eat the chocolate. We didn't get a say over that, so let's just assume it will do the right thing. So I remember we did have, see the typewriter, if you remember in episode 1. there was a typewriter in the suitcase, and it's still there. So again, clicking on the typewriter, almost perfect. I've got to find that bloody lighter. Again, another chance to sit down. What have we got in here? Bible. Yes, one thing that would be quite good to interact with items you pick up. You can specifically click on certain things on the item you pick up, but as I just said, you can't seem to do that. Play with the radio, doesn't do much. Just turn it off. And in this drawer, seems like we found a Zippo lighter. This is initialed, so it's our initials. So you can see in our inventory in the top right, we've now got our lighter and our cigarettes. Maybe I'm nosing around a bit too much. Maybe I'm doing things too early on. But lots of photos. Can't interact with them. Can't get in the safe. To open and to close the door by entering a 4-digit number and pressing the hash key. Okay, well, it's already closed. To open, enter the same 4-digit key. Well, I haven't got a clue. Anyone see any numbers here? 1013. Let's try that for a laugh. Like that. Again, as I said in episode 2, you know, I'm not claiming to be amazing at games, but I might miss something, so if I'm being really stupid, just let me know in the comments and put me right. Why not? Right, now he wants to write. Let's write a story, see what's going on. Oh, blimey, you can see what's right up here. Obviously didn't appreciate that page that he just wrote. This is relating to episode 1, when we saw the lady throw herself off the edge of the balcony in the hotel. Looks at it, this is inspiration. And he'd like some more wine. It's almost like this character was made almost about me in real life. I do love a wine. And he seems to like red as well, so fair play to him, corkscrew. That'll come in handy for more wine. So I'm assuming we've got to get more wine. And we knew that there was a bottle, as this says, in the fridge. Let's have some of this. Actually, I don't know. This is red wine, because the colour scheme in this game isn't exactly colourful. It's black and white. Oh, that's definitely red. No, that's all right, then. I wouldn't bother with white, to be honest. But, there we go. Let's get more drunk. And carry on writing, apparently. Let's try again.
Room service.
Who's that at the door?
Room service.
Not actually anyone there. I think our top right just moved, but what's actually on this trolley? Nothing. Is she just a prank caller? Nothing doing. Nothing doing. Let's close and go back. No more interruptions, probably. Perhaps we're getting a bit pissed off now. So, let's carry on. Maybe we can finish the story at some point. Who knows?
Housekeeping
now. Now you can tell this guy's getting more and more annoyed. Can't they leave me alone? And I've noticed I've left the fridge open. I feel terrible about that. Let's close that. What do they want now? Let's have a look. Ooh, bloodstains. Ooze blood. And scissors. Do we dare go and have a look? I suppose we should. Yet again, nobody there. Bloodstain, more bloodstain stuff. And the scissors, which we can take. Bloodstained again, you can see glinting. That's potentially a murder weapon or something. Let's take those scissors. Never run with scissors, by the way. It's dangerous, so we'll walk back to my desk, especially after lots of wine. Okay, so just leave me alone. Used to be the theme. So what does he want us to do? Does he want us to carry on typing? Right, here we go. This guy seems to appear very troubled. Doesn't seem very happy.
Thank you for choosing the Azure Hotel. We hope you're enjoying our services. Is there anything we can get you to help you enjoy your stay?
Ooh, leave me the hell alone. It's impossible to get some peace. Yeah, I think that's the kind of reaction John would give, so let's go.
Of course, Mr. Evans. I know exactly what you need.
What's next? Well, indeed. Are you waiting for room service? What's... Okay, we'll stand up and we'll see what we can do.
Room service.
Room service, right on time. I'm pretty sure he didn't ask for this, but... if it's free, I'm inclined to take free food. We're moving the whole trolley in. Excellent. Let's close this door. Or not, I can't close the door. There we go. Yeah. Sushi or scallops? Aha, wine. And obviously a hammer, because that's the kind of thing that gets brought up on a plate, and some champagne. Yeah, why not? I guess I'll take the hammer. Thanks. I'm not even typing. Noise coming from. Oh! What's he doing? So I'm assuming he's boarding up the windows and. Oh, you can see up here. No. Well, oh, that's not normal, is it? Let's be honest. So he doesn't want to be disturbed, I think we can tell that. Are these doors still locked? I can hear like gas or something. Chapter 2. Continue writing then. This descent into madness, potentially. Should that date change as well? We've actually been stuck in here a day. More wine. More wine. How about some help? Cigarette. This is getting really annoying. People should just leave you alone. Well, we know you don't want to be disturbed. I guess he needs more wine. Let's take a bowl. And another bowl? No, just wanted the one bowl. Only one of those disappeared into the ether, so fine. What about here? What's that tapping? painting. Seems to be rattling. Hit it. Okay. 7. That must be one of the numbers. 4 are safe. But also we see the water coming through our wall, which is a bit odd, but we'll live with it. We'll go with it. So, what else? Oh, our typewriter's gone. He wants more wine, but it looks a bit one more. Let's go back to our fridge. And we're not going to consume that one for some reason. We didn't. Oh, there's a glass. We'll drink that. Peace. We need peace.
To answer these and other personal problems
that's
by your friends and neighbors, Arad
TV.
John J. Anthony, founder of the famed Marital Relations Institute, in a...
Okay, so we've got water coming out of the TV. Standard plumbing. Tricked you, and the wine glass is filled up. We have more wine. Let's drink the wine, I guess. More banging. Make it stop. These are moving now. Just seems to want to hit everything. Oh, I guess there'll be water again. Nope, there is water. No explanation to any of this. But I'm prepared to go with it. 0. Another number. But I was hoping we'd get a number from that. There's a number at the bottom of the TV screen. 3. So we've got a 7, a 3, and a 0. And one more glass of wine. This is now annoying in an event. 7. That was 3, wasn't it? So I'm assuming there'll be another number. 730. Is there another number? 6 or 9? 730 or 6 or 9? Let's go and try this. 7306. 7309. Hey! That's a 9. I guess we can open it. Ooh, sinister. A gun. With any bullets? No bullets. Keen on this guy having a gun though, not in his state. Now we've got a new door. Bathroom. Turn the radio on. It might calm down a bit. Okay, so we can't get out of the bathroom. We can't get out of that way. Do we need a toilet? No. No, just opening the lid. Why not? All the fun of staying in a hotel, eh? What we got here? I will never leave you. I assume this is his wedding ring. Part of the mystery. Is he married? Is he married? If he was or is, who is the wife? A watch? The time everywhere seems to say about 10 past 10, doesn't it? To the other side. Some marks, that might be blood, or it could just be wear and tear on that left hand side, who knows? Let's turn the tap on, I guess. Not sure he'd be doing anything. bath. Turn the water on. And that one. So what now? Maybe we can't get out of the room. Running a bath. Oh, here we go. Look inside yourself. Another gun. And another pair of scissors. Well, I thought we'd already got the scissors and we already got a gun. This one's got a bullet. Oh dear. And the scissors have gone. That looked like a choice almost. We'll see how we go from there. It's taken a somewhat quite a dark turn. Gun on the side of the bath. Okay, what's happening here then? So, oh, did he shoot himself? Well, that was that wasn't expecting that to happen, to be honest with you. It just seemed like a bit of a strange room. End of Act One. It was a bit haunting there. I think we'll end that episode there. Yeah, very dark story, but hope you like that, and we'll see you in episode 4. Thank you very much. Catch you later.